for liposuction? That's actually a very, very good question. Well, number one, are you healthy? Do you have diabetes? Do you have a history of coronary artery disease? Do you have problems with coagulation? Those might be important factors actually to discuss before liposuction, but any procedure overall. Now, a common question is, am I too old to have liposuction? Well, actually, technically speaking, any patient can have a liposuction. So age per se, being too young or too old, really is not a strict contraindication for liposuction. Really, what I would say, more importantly, is that you are healthy. If you are healthy, if you are eating right, sleeping well, doing exercise, that's probably a good indication that you are going to be a good patient for liposuction. And also, this is very important because the recovery, many times it depends on how healthy the patient is. For example, if somebody has diabetes and the blood sugars are elevated, they are out of control, that patient probably might have more risk to have complications, not only from liposuction, but for any procedure. We have done hundreds of patients with actually diabetes. So what we do is that we control the blood sugar, we do blood tests, and actually we put patients on our program. Actually it's a coach lifestyle program in which we made the patient actually lose weight. And many patients actually in the diabetes goes away. So in overall, to try to answer that question in regards to you, a contraindication is that the patient actually has to be healthy. But being unhealthy or having diseases that sometimes the patient is not responsible for actually having those diseases is not either a contraindication to have a liposuction. What about if I have liposuction before? Can I have liposuction again? The answer is yes. Actually, I would say that the majority, I would say a big percentage of patients that we do liposuction in our facility are patients who had liposuction before, or patients who already had abdominoplasty or tummy tuck. So yes, if you got liposuction before, you can have liposuction done again. However, it's a good idea to wait. At least usually most of the time I wait 7 months to a year and a half, ideally, because you have to let the body to heal properly after the liposuction. These are different stages of healing after the liposuction. Many patients ask me, well, I have C-section before, and I have this little pouch here. I'm not obese or anything, I just have this little pouch that doesn't go away with diet and exercise. So what happens sometimes is that because of the scar, if the scar is a horizontal, it's like you have a breach in there, like a scar tissue that makes the patient to have a little pouch. So yes, patients like that, they can have liposuction. There's no problem doing that. But actually what we do is that we undermine the scar tissue during the liposuction procedure without doing any incision or cutting or anything like that. So that's in regards to the patient. Now, is the patient having allergies? If you have severe allergies, for example, to lidocaine, which is one of the main ingredients that we use for pain during the liposuction, during what we call the tumescent fluid, then that might be probably a strong contraindication to lidocaine. But again, we have to find out exactly what happened when that patient had the lidocaine. So those are in regards to the patient. So we look at the patient, right? And also now we are looking exactly the patient's body. So a common question is, am I too obese to have liposuction? Well, let's define obesity. Normal BMI, which is actually a calculation between the patient's height and the patient's weight, is between 20 to 25. That's considered normal. Between 25 to 30 is what is called overweight. You are a little bit overweight there. And more than 30 is what is called obesity. However, we have to be careful when we are using the BMI because sometimes patients have good muscle mass and the BMI might be high and they have a very, very tiny excess fat deposit. So again, you have to look at every patient individually. Don't look at it as a general rule. So the BMI, is that a contraindication? Is that an absolute contraindication for liposuction? But the answer is not. You can have a BMI that is more than 30, and if you are healthy, exercising, losing weight, why not having liposuction? One of the main things is that obesity is associated with complications. Not of liposuction only, but actually any operation or any disease. Actually, patients who are obese, they tend to be more prone to develop complications from the flu, from the pneumonia, and so forth. So obesity, of course, we don't want to be obese, but again, we have to remember that the liposuction, what it does, it removes the excess fat deposit, the subcutaneous excess fat deposits. So if the patient is obese, they need to lose also what we call a visceral fat, meaning the fat surrounding the intestines, the liver, the spleen, any fat that is inside. So it's very important that the patient at the same time as doing undergoing a liposuction, they also start losing weight if the BMI is too high. Now, one of the things that we try to do, and actually we do in every patient, is that we do a complete screening in that patient with blood tests, past medical history, past surgical history, medications, hospitalization. So we got a good indication if that patient could be a good candidate for liposuction. So it's very important that your physician does actually perform a good evaluation, a good questionnaire for make sure that you are healthy, right? So that's very, very important. Now, the objective or the goal of the liposuction is actually to improve your body, to improve your silhouette. So let's say you have excess fat deposit here, you are straight, like for example in this picture right here, you could see I got this one right here in my consultation room and I show to my patients, look at the straight line right here. This is straight, this is straight. So the idea is actually to create the curvatures. I put this one, I got this picture in here, this painting on purpose, because most of the patients, they come like this. They don't have curvatures because of the excess fat deposit. Many women, they do have a good, actually, silhouette, but because they have gained weight, then they lose that nice curvature. So the goal of the liposuction is to improve the patient's silhouette. And again, in another video, we'll talk about the techniques for liposuction, the safety of liposuction. But the goal of the liposuction really is to improve your silhouette. The liposuction can be done really in any area, on the face, on the neck, on the arms, on the belly, on the chest. Many men with gynecomasty, we do liposuction in the back, on the legs. Really any area we can do liposuction. Of course, there has to be excess fat deposits to perform liposuction. Remember, these are indications for cosmetic indication for liposuction, but there are also indication for liposuction, for example, when we just want to do a fat transfer, let's say a fat transfer to the face or to the hands, without performing a full body liposuction. It just basically, what I mean by that is that we just remove a small volume of fat, but the idea is not to do a sculpting. Remember, the main idea of the liposuction, my personal opinion, is to do a sculpting of the body, because if you just remove fat, okay, you are just doing liposuction. So basically the idea is to do what is called liposculpture, meaning you are going to sculpt the body, which is actually more advanced than just doing liposuction. Liposuction is just fat harvesting, and the liposculpture is basically taking the time, the techniques that we use to sculpt the body. So in that way, the outcome is having the patient, let's say the patient wants curvatures on their hip areas. So the idea is that the patient have nice curvatures, of the patient be able to put a dress properly, and it shows the proper curvatures on the body, or they go to the pool and they want to have a flat stomach, they actually can show that, because now the excess fat deposits actually are reduced. So again, that's one of the main goals of the liposuction. The liposuction is not a method to lose weight. Many patients, they come, well, how many pounds can I lose doing a liposuction? So, well, again, I say the same thing I'm saying now in this video. is that the objective or the main goal of the liposuction is to do sculpting. Many patients might be obese, but once we provide the curvatures, then that patient is going to show up their own body. Of course, if they have excess fat deposits inside, meaning the visceral fat, that patient then needs to lose weight, right? Diet, exercise, and so forth. Now, something very important too is that a common question is, well, I have a skin laxity, I'm obese, I have a skin laxity, my skin is hanging, right? So depending on how severe is the skin laxity, then we might decide to perform liposuction or not. Now, many patients, they don't want to go for a abdominoplasty or tummy tuck because they are afraid of complications. It's most of the time it's done on the general anesthesia. Mainly they are afraid of the scar also plus the complications. So an approach that we do is to perform a liposculpture and the patient got, let's say, skin laxity, then of course, you know, it's communicated to the patient that they might continue to have some degree of skin laxity depending on the patient, the skin type and all that. And then we can do a combination of liposuction combined with other techniques, for example, the J-plasma or Renovion, which is actually to help you sustain the skin tightening. But again, those are not replacements for a full abdominoplasty. I just want to make that clear. So again, that's an alternative, but it's not a replacement. So now all depends also on the patient's expectations, right? If, let's say, somebody, they want just to have a sculpting on their body, they want to have this flat, and they are okay or having a little bit of a skin laxity, if any, then, you know, liposuction with the, for example, J-plasma, if indicated, is a good alternative because the goal is basically able to pull the dress so the fat doesn't come out like this in the front or in the back and have a curvature. So there are different techniques that we do during the liposuction procedure. For example, skin tightening techniques, plus also the equipment that we use during the procedure. Sometimes we use two liposuction machines, depending on what we're going to achieve and what is the goal on that patient. I'll give you an example. If let's say somebody already had liposuction before, 5-10 years ago, and during the examination I palpated, it's a very fibrotic fat that we call it, it's like a basically scar tissue that develops. Then, you know, sometimes we use a combination machines to actually break up all that scar tissue. So that's basically, you know, the idea of the liposuction. Now, something very important, and again, that's my philosophy. I only do one liposuction a day, or liposculpture a day, only one. The reason being because, again, like I mentioned before, we want to do a sculpting on that patient. And number two, I prefer not to use any general anesthesia. So usually all the patients that we do is without any general anesthesia. And so the question is, how do I manage the pain? How do I remove the fat without any general anesthesia? There is a solution called the tumescent fluid, which actually contains the contains three ingredients, which is the lidocaine, the epinephrine, and the bicarb. And the lidocaine is for the pain. The epinephrine is to diminish blood bleeding, and the bicarb is the to lower the pH of the lidocaine. So again, there is a special technique that we use to actually infiltrate the abdomen, the back, probably in less than 20 minutes or half an hour, depending on how big is the patient. But this is very important because I want my patients to be talking to me during the liposuction. Most of them, they go to sleep. We do a very light sedation by mouth. But overall, the patients are alert, awake. And again, they are pain-free. They have to be pain-free because I won't be able to perform a procedure like a liposuction if somebody's in pain. It's impossible.